Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. Today we are going to do a regular old run, though we got a lot of the challenges done. Let's use the random button again. Oh, I'm on greed. Well, can't cancel it now. I just played Lazarus. Anyway, I don't want to play greed anyway. Hard mode, random. It's just me finding an excuse to play Lazarus anyway. So what are we missing with Lazarus is the real question. Oh, it thinks we're missing the cathedral and the dark room. Well, that's kind of inconvenient, don't you think? I don't exactly have a way to handle that, but I need to do Hush, Mega Satan, Cathedral, and Dark Room. Inconveniently. Hey, it's a luck up. I don't believe it. Oh, here's the... Yeah, you saw the seed, because I was looking at what we need to do. I guess I'll go for Dark Room. But, like, going for Dark Room and Mega Satan on the same run is such a bad idea. It's, like... Dark Room doesn't give you anything to make your run any better, basically. Shouldn't have taken that. I need to die first. Forgot I'm Lazarus, basically. So, then trying to get the keys from the Angel Rooms, which, again, just like the Dark Room, don't give you anything to help you out. You're just basically trying to complete the hardest stuff with no, like, nothing good in your build, unless you're really lucky. Alright, so I'm gonna have to sacrifice this soul heart here, because I need to die and revive as revived Lazarus for my stat boost. So, hoping there's a sacrifice room somewhere. They haven't been changed, by the way. They are still just bad. That wasn't really worth it, but hey. Use the tower for this. Get my job done for me decently enough. Or not. Both secret rooms, though. Let's just say that was part of the plan. Ugh, run into the fire. You, the magician. Homing tears for a room. I decided I didn't want to fight those spiders, so I didn't. All good. Okay. Wow, I actually got that through in the one moment I had the chance to. That's cool. Okay, so there was no sacrifice room, and I didn't go to the top secret room. I'll give it my money, because that could happen. Okay, I have 3 bombs, which I can easily kill myself with. Ah, perfect. This is exactly the boss that I would hope to use the... use item on. Does 10 damage to every enemy in the room and slows them all as well. It's not that good, but when you have a bunch of segments like Larry Jr. is, it's certainly at its best. By the way, you can actually get drops from poops now without the trinket. Okay, so that's a health up. Perfect. That means I'm good to die. Sadly, I left nothing to conveniently die on, so I have to use my bombs or something. We're going here. Die on the fire. Shoot one of them. Oh no, I've died. But actually, I just respawned with anemic. And some other good stuff. Because anemic isn't actually good, and my stats otherwise are pretty good. Let's get to 5 cents so we can get an arcade just in case we care. Let's go get our soul hearts. Glad that can't hurt you, because I do that every time. Alright. Let's go this way. And then let's go pick up our health up. And we are in good shape. So remember, if I want to guarantee I can fight Mega Satan, I want to not take Devil Room items. But if there's something really good, I'm just going to do it and not worry about Mega Satan yet. There's a ton of time I can fight Mega Satan, like, any time from the rest of now to forever. So, it's not a huge worry. And if I try to do everything in one run, like I said, it just makes my life way harder. So I think it's an okay thing not to do. And then I'm gonna get the bomb chest. Is this? Okay, it's double key. Makes sense. Nice. And I can use a key for this. That's totally fine with me. Okay, so this is my secret room. You can use that to check if you're crafty. Okay, so at least I got a pretty fly. Orbital. Blocks tears, kills flies. Okay, just gonna take this nice and slow. But remember, I do have to be beating the heart at 30 minutes. So, can't just take forever for fun or anything. Aha, I outplayed you. 0.3 damage up, chance to shoot a tear that concusses enemies, causes them moderate discomfort, I guess. It makes them wander around stupidly, and it's actually kind of confusing. Sorry. Yeah. Not the best effect that you can put on an enemy. But it's not the worst either. What was this? The Magician. Yeah, okay, I'll take the Devil. 2 damage up for a room. Okay, we're actually in a really good spot as far as health is concerned right now. I'm not going to finish exploring the floor most likely because I want to make sure to save all the time I can while I can. Okay, so those don't count as flies, I guess? Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Kill all the small ones right away. Nice. I didn't actually think I'd get away with that. But that's what health is for, I guess. Let's fight nerds. Monstro. I like that. I do like that. Should be easy. Yeah, he went weird places. Like, I don't know his patterns when he's concussed, so it's dangerous. Speed up? Sure. Great, just what I needed. These enemies are just really just not cool at all. They just dodge. Takes forever to kill them. That's how it's probably better to kill them that way. So the game forced me not to take a deal with the Devil, so now I can get angel rooms. We're all good. Okay. They have more than 10 health, but they're probably, yeah, all one shot now. Wow, that hit. I am surprised. So as long as I find item room and boss room, that's all I really care about right now. I don't have enough money for a shop. Now I kind of want to just get hit. Screw it. Okay, that should be good enough. This is a lot more useful than I usually give it credit for. Right now, getting a lot of things nearly done with it. Okay, flight and an eternal heart is actually very useful. Now I can maneuver as freely as anything, I guess. Wow, they still have 3 hits in them. Or more, they had 4, dang. They have a lot of health, I guess. All good. Okay, just stand still, I says. That's like one shot speed up. It's kind of silly, actually. I think it makes it a little too hard to aim with the shot speed I have, at least. So unless in here, no, I do not have what I would say is worth it, which is one of the things that gives me minimum shot speed. Well, I'm gonna try this anyway. Power pill. which you can see what it is. Invincibility and contact damage from the Game Kid. Then I got I think it's called the Evil Eye. Empress is 1.5 damage up and 0.3 speed up for a room. It's not technically better than the Devil in this case, because I'm already way faster than I need to be, so I guess I'll stick with what I had. I did find the item room, so we're all good. Champion Belt's not worth it at all anymore, because it makes bosses higher chance to be champions as well, and you get a lot of unfair rooms because of that. So it's actually just kind of a garbage item now, because it just makes the game unfair. Oops, I didn't know it would run out so soon. I didn't think... Ah, whatever. I'm bad at Gerda Jr. That's really all there is to it, all you need to know. Magic Mushroom, all stats up, including 1.5 damage multiplier. So I got the Evil Eye, which is a chance when I shoot that I shoot out. You know this is worth using this for, and I was kind of stuck there. And that's a chance I shoot out an eye that shoots out my tears. Oh, my invincibility ran out. At a decent rate, maybe it's equal to my fire rate, or approximately equal to my fire rate. And we're getting our first key piece. Picking up the key piece means we're going to be more likely to get angel rooms instead of devil rooms here. Everything is looking good. Oh, he spawned, dude. And this is a pretty good run. We got a Celtic Cross in the first, or in the angel room. And that means that when I get hit, there's a 20% chance. Yeah, 20%. That I get about 7 seconds of invincibility. I never actually managed to do that quickly enough to not have to worry about dodging the things even a little bit. Okay. Yeah, they still have a lot of health, but these guys don't. Okay. Everything's fine. Are you a wizard? I would say no. Totally worthwhile room to use this on, especially because you get it right back because it's a two room charge, and that L rooms and quad rooms give you two rooms of charge. Magical. I'm just using this thing everywhere. It's great. Still haven't found the item room. I also want to go to the shop. Shop is pretty much definitely on the way to the boss. Almost always is. So that works. But item room can be anywhere. So hopefully we run into it. If you can get a lot of eyes firing, it's a really good item. Especially as your fire rate gets better. Ooh, two shot. Well, wasn't on the way to the boss, so I'm gonna have to go back. But we're making all right time, so it's not a big deal. Joker. Now that's exactly what I need to see. That is exactly what I need to see. This is a room worth using this on. Still gonna take a few hits to kill them all. It's a slow process. This is my shop, and I don't want to buy anything in here. I will bomb this. Could give me a nickel, could give me a greed, could give me a lot of things. I already have a magic mushroom, so I don't need to bomb any mushrooms. Don't really care about the mushroom transformation. Don't know if it does anything besides give you health up in a mushroom hat. Alright, there we go. I don't really want the Eternal Heart. Pick it up, I guess, but I don't want it. Let's roll it. Totes. Should have about zero luck right now. But if I can get some luck up, that's good. There is a luck up pill. Actually, I'll check if there was one in the shop. I have a 1 over 10 minus luck chance to fire a tooth. Tooth does 3.2 times my damage. It's a good thing to get. But that's the solid blue pill, the one I start with, pill number one, actually. So this boss, not a big deal. Just stay kind of in front of him, vertically. That's, I guess, in front or behind vertically. Just stay vertical to it. When it goes down, you can pretty much instantly have it come back up. That's why I didn't take a health up, in case I got a good one. All stats up. Alright, so now we're gonna have our second key piece already, and all we have to do is actually not die. We can start taking devil runes again, which is another fantastic piece of, dang, reality. So hopefully we get one of those, like, next floor. Especially since that one didn't stay, that means that we didn't lose the chance to earn it on this floor. Curse the blind, inconvenient. But I will blindly take devil room items, they're not a big deal. Like, there's only so bad that things could get. Ooh, that was close. Haven't seen this room in a long time. Oops. That's fine, I have spare keys. And if I get all the hard stuff out of the way first try with Lazarus, that's good. Sure, just use it all the time, man. Alright, blind. Just take it. Big fan, not a bad pickup. Blocks tears, slow movement speed, decent damage. Didn't get a teleport, unfortunately. I won't still be invincible by the time they attack, so I won't just tank a teleport out of the room. I would have if I wouldn't do it, if I would have been invincible still. It would have totally been worth it. It's probably also worth it to bomb those, but I'm not going to. I'm doing alright. I have 6 health though. I need a devil room to get rid of some of this health. I have way too much of it. But since I'm going to Dark Room anyway, it doesn't really matter if I have red hearts or soul hearts. I can have any set of any kinds of hearts. Yeah, that's what I expected. Curse of the Tower is a chance when I get hit to activate the tower effect, spawn troll bombs around the room. It's funny, but it often can chain itself and just kind of like kill you. Figured it'd be pretty safe right about now. Half-hearted damage to kill most of the enemies in the room. I'm down. Okay, now I'm just you, probably. Cool. We'll kill you, and then we'll kill all of them. Easy. So next time I get an orbital, the pretty fly. Excuse me. I would have warned you, but it came on very suddenly. The pretty fly will probably slow down to match the big fan. So that's a thing to note. I've already been to the item room, perfect. I don't really recommend shops and Curse the Blind. Just kind of asking for trouble. Fine. I was trying to get him to destroy one of the fires for me. That's one good thing to do in this fight. Curse the Tower. Maybe Curse the Tower is a guarantee. Oops. Dang, that was a mess. Range up. Is that my first mom's item? Probably. Yeah, let's go. Didn't get our devil room. Okay. One dude that was actually an enemy here. Hadn't considered that. Changes the dynamic of this room. Not a big deal. Definitely worth slowing this, speeding this room up, slowing the enemies down and whatnot. I need some fiery, dang. And some luck. And some tinted rock. Okay. That was easy. Perfect spot here. There is no curse. Oh, how fantastic. Mom's eye. It's a mom item, so. Chance to fire out of the back of my head, luck based. I think I need one more luck for it to be every time. This way I can get both of the items, so why not? Piggy bank gives me 3 cents. Makes it so that when I get hit, I drop money that I didn't already have. Humbling bundle makes it so that all keys, bombs, full hearts, and pennies drop as double pickups. So it means I don't really have to worry about my resources at all. That's good. And I need one mom item to become the mom transformation, which would get me a knife trailing around after me that I can't really use very effectively, but it exists. Anyway, that's a plus. Come on. There we are. Oh, by the way. Yeah, totes. Sure. Strength card's magic mushroom for a room, which means it won't give me the multiplier that I already have. Anyway, lucky pennies will not be able to spawn as double pennies, so we'll always be able to tell if there's a lucky penny drop in a room, because it won't be a double penny like a normal one will. So that's kind of cool. Makes Humbling Bundle useful. If you're going to be at max money, you don't have to pick up every coin in case of a luck up. Which is just nice. Like, I assume that's unintended, but it's just, it's a really cool thing that I like existing. Apparently they didn't fix the mom cheese. Even though they, like, did. Oops. Dark room. Wafer. Oh, that's huge. No reason to fight the statue. I already have the full key. Wafer means that all damage is only going to be a half a heart. Holy light has to happen. Holy light, luck-based shot, luck-based chance to fire a glowing tear. If that glowing tear hits an enemy, it hits has a beam of light attack the enemy as well, which does 3 times your damage. So it does 4 times your damage overall. And it is super good. It is like one of the best new tier effects. And I assume if it hits with the tooth, it'll do 9 times your damage probably. But I don't know that for sure. Excuse me? I feel like a great injustice has just befallen me. Also a little bothered that you can go over gaps. So what I need right now is a way to farm luck ups, rather desperately. And yeah, I'm pretty sure the evil eye can shoot glowing ones as well. Yeah, it can. Alright, buddy. I'll probably still get the 0.3 damage up from using the strength card, by the way, and I'll get the heart. So I may as well use it for a bit of recovery here. Just casually doing a boss rush here. Oh yeah, I can use this every wave. Forgot about that. I was totally out of the way, you liar. At least he can't jump over the gap. Like Mega Fatty apparently can. Okay. Thank you for attacking that way. About to die. Perfect. Get on the gap. kills them pretty effectively. Excuse me? Oh, that's what hit me. I was like, what just hit me? And I realized. Oh! I didn't even know that was the boss that was over there. If I die to this, it's gonna be so silly. I'm just kind of pathetic. But I'm totally not very far in boss rush. I'm totally very dead so far. I just did not know what was going on. Okay, you know what? I should kill this guy first. Frail is a threat. Okay, good. Oh, you popped up right there. Everything is terrible. Everything is terrible. Hello. You're fine. I don't mind you. I don't think I've even fought the Death Wave yet. Death is the scariest part of boss rush. There he is. It's those gosh darn sides, man. At least Pin is, like, completely harmless. The sides are already handled, though, so that's, like, totally cool. Come on. Shouldn't really have used that there. Should have waited to use it. Oh, well, I'm glad I was there instead of where he was about to laser. But he is gonna mostly kill the boss for me. That was nice. I actually think the new boss rush is less fun, by the way, where it randomly decides the enemies that it's gonna spawn. Because it just means it's more likely you get screwed. I don't like it very much, but I also don't like that you don't get four items most of the time. Most of the time it's one of the two item boss rush rooms. Or, you know, they're spikes, so you have to pay health to get to them if you don't have flight. It's just... to me, it's less good. But that's okay. I want to kill you first, for sure. Plus side here is I do have the wafer. God dang it. That's why I wanted to kill the adversary first. You ever want to stop lasering, buddy? Okay, he's dead, so he'll stop lasering now. I need some full health. I also have no clue when the boss rush is going to end with the new system. Because I'm not busy counting to 15. Ooh, that was scary. I actually killed the small one first. That's pretty rare. Eh. Oh wow, and it gave me Holy Mantle. What a guy. It's like, yeah, I know what I did to you. What you really did to yourself, though. That was 100% on me. Okay. So Holy Mantle, I can get hit once per room, and it won't count as me getting hit. Little buddy that shoots piercing tears, why not? Not like my other trinket works. Like, on-hit effects don't work with Holy Mantle. They just don't. Because you're not getting hit. So why have one if I'm only gonna try and use Holy Mantle for my hits? Instead, have something that does a little more damage for me. 5 cents I can't really use. Let's just use this. hate these enemies, though. They just suck. But it's cool. There we go. That's what I'm waiting for. Holy light activation. How you get stuff done. Thank you. No tinted rock. Really, it's just a dead end. That was necessary. Just wait for that. Because of course it's gonna pop back up at the worst possible moment. Cool. Hinn just died. Well, I guess I'm going left. Direction that, you know, you learn never to trust. I would like to not lose my devil room chance, because I really would like a devil room here. Yeah, I decided screw it. No tinted rock, really? Common tinted rock room. It's nice that Teeth one-shot a lot of enemies. Having Holy Mantle means that this curse room is free. It's already free to enter because I have flight, but it's free to leave thanks to Holy Mantle. I hate big rooms with those dudes. Okay, so the secret room is here. Well, there's no reason to bomb him. Not really even a reason to go do that, but I did. Nice, both of them died. Okay, if there's not a tinted rock in here, I'll be amazed. But it looks like there actually isn't. Second pretty fly, so now all of my orbitals are slow. There's really not. Goodness. Yeah, just run them into the spikes, the easiest way. Since I have flight, not dangerous. I need more of the blue pill, man. It's fine. Oh, this one you gotta move. They changed the way this room works because these guys move more with their beam still out now. So if you don't move out of the way, you're actually just getting hit and it's not up to you. I didn't react soon enough, so I got hit anyway, but that's what Holy Mantle's for. Okay. Daddy Longlegs is a horrible boss. Getting hit isn't up to you at all. Okay, what are you? Safety pin, black heart, and then range and shot speed up. Trinity Shield, I don't mind anymore. It actually has like a working hitbox. So that's pretty cool. I'm not making Hush, so that's unfortunate. This gets me full health. Okay. And there goes Hush right now. It's unfortunate. Boss Rush took a little longer than I could afford, though. I might have been able to beat Hush, but I'll just do it another run that's, you know, not limited to Mega Satan and Dark Room, which is like a lot of restriction, honestly. That means it's so unlikely that I can get anything good. Oh, it actually let me go through the room and it was the wrong way. I should have taken the warning, basically. It was like, hey, don't go this way. It's like, but I want to. It's not right. Like, well, you could have said that more straightforward. Hey. Joker. 5, redo the floor. I don't see a reason I'd really want to do that. What is this? Empress, okay. Like, it's a little late for the redo the floor thing. Doesn't offer me anything that I want. So it is. Okay. This way. So for those who don't know, I have achieved 100% on the stream save now. That includes like Keeper, all the Mega Satan stuff, Lost, everything's done. All that remains is picking up one item. It's super rare, so I'm gonna get done eventually. But I officially have done all the stuff, so you're no longer spoiling stuff for me. So that's good. I didn't really care about spoilers anyway, because I knew I couldn't avoid them. Okay, that's fine. This probably saves me time. Good teleport. Ha, I knew not to trust it every time. Okay, eventually I will hit it. There you go, I hit it. Okay, this is the worry. It is now handled. Alright, there we go. I should be able to sit still. Trinity Shield should protect me. At long last, its hitbox is, like, not a bad thing. So I should be able to get by without worrying about dodging. God, I love the Holy Light effect. It's so effective. Okay, use this then. The Mind, great item. Gives me a full map for the floor. Okay. And of course I get Curse of the Lost immediately. Why wouldn't I? Two black hearts, not bad. Remember I have Wafer and Wafer and Holy Mantle. So I don't have to worry about losing much health. For pretty much any reason. Oh, that was lucky. Now I can actually see you. Wow, that was a lot of holy light right there. Feel bad for the enemies. Okay. Ah, you totes should have died, man. It's a good thing I can fly. Because this room has some bad timings where you're just not avoiding damage. You gotta be really proactive to guarantee that you won't get hit. Okay, so there was no left door, right? Correct. So left it is. Okay, these guys actually get off the wall now a lot quicker, which is good. That was one of the changes that I thought would have been pretty fantastic, because then they actually become an enemy that matters, as opposed to an enemy that you just always kill even with a bad build. And so it's like, my build is kind of bad right now, but it's not a big deal. Hopefully I get some stuff in the chest, the dark room that is. Because of course I do have to kill the lamb. I can't just go kill Mega Satan, because I'm missing the lamb thing because of the import glitch. So you know, that's always nice. And yeah, of course I could have re-imported. There was a tinted rock, I'll get it. I could have re-imported, but it was too late. I'd already made more progress than I cared to lose by the time that was fixed. Because I don't have a problem just doing all the post-it note stuff again, because I'll eventually do it anyway, naturally. Okay, first thing, Tinted Rock is here. Looks like no other tinted rocks, which is not a big deal either. Okay. Be nice if I just, like, holy light a dude. Anytime. Those guys are weird. Like, they just accept your influence as far as movement is concerned really easily. Wish I had the black candle. That candle's just such a swell dude. I've had the full map, secret rooms and everything. But I found my way. Means I actually have to kill this monster too. By the way, my item has gotten to the point of being completely useless, pretty much. That's why I haven't been using it. It, like, makes no difference except slowing down my DPS. So, you know, not gonna bother. So now Satan fight. I really suck at the Satan fight for some strange reason. I pressed Q instead of E. I don't know why, but I did. Oh, there goes Holy Mantle. I'm not very concerned with that, though. Curse of the Tower. What a guy. Yeah, you can do that if you want. Doesn't make a difference. Should be no problem. Because the Holy Light. So the hooves don't do contact damage to you once they've finished stomping, so you can just run into them, especially if you have something like the virus. You just go for it, man. Alright, to the dark room. Hopefully we'll just get three guppy pieces right here, right away. No curse, oh thank goodness. Well, more chests, that's actually really good. More chests, less other drops. I don't need other drops, so... Hey, great. Charge, charge, charge. I'm doing time. Okay, that's one. Perfect. Oops. Okay, now let's bomb our way into the secret room. I don't actually mind doing all the rooms here. That's something that could really come back to bite me, though. But I have Guppy's Tail now, so I'm getting more chests, which means more items, because all the chests are going to contain items. So it seems silly to me not to maximize my chance for some good items to show up. Thanks. Of course, the game could always decide, screw you, I'm not going to give you anything. This happens. Luck down. Oh well. This is a good item. And I got the mom transformation, which is kind of inconsequential, but happened. So mom's wig. Chance whenever I'm holding shoot to spawn a spider. Does 2.5 times my damage. And it can spawn up to 5 spiders. At like max at a time, you can have 5 spiders from it. Once they die, you can get more again. It's cool, dude. See, it's cool. More items, please. Tower. It's alright. I don't know what's up with that top secret room. I get it a lot now. I mean, I would imagine that I can handle Mega Satan already. Just because I have so much tankiness. And an okay build. Okay. Really? That's fine. That is fine as well. Trinity Shield will do my work for me as far as dodging this is concerned. This dude shouldn't be a big deal. Yeah, do it all you want. Keep doing that attack forever, honestly. This can actually hit me. Wouldn't be surprised. Didn't, but Could have. That's the only attack. Like, I can't dodge that attack. You have to pretty much already be moving. And I never know, like, I don't know when it does that attack. Because it's not, like, telegraphed or anything. It's just like, hey, screw you. Feel free to get hit. So. I just kind of accept it with that attack. Sucks that I have to redo this with the Lost, because it gave me this instead of the... Or it gave me the chest instead of the dark room when I actually got... Oof, wish I hadn't chosen this room. Oh, so that just didn't even do anything. That's good. I appreciate that the mass freeze didn't work. It still says mass fear, too, even though it's a freeze. I don't know why they never fixed that. Come on, you're almost dead. I know it. I know you, monster, too. Not a big deal. It's half a heart. Okay, if this gives me an item, I'll continue doing rooms. Good. Never mind, I don't need to continue doing rooms, do I? Proptosis will do just fine. Scaling damage multiplier based on range. 2.0 at the closest, 1.3 at the farthest. Unless it was nerfed. I don't know. Okay, that's fine. Trinity Shield means I'm really not concerned with things. That mom's eye, man. Doing so much free work for me. So it's nice to get a Mega Satan win out of the way. Not too worried that this one won't win. I didn't get hit. I'm the one that towers. Okay, get out of the way, hands. See if that's laser. It is. Too bad the game doesn't know that I've already beaten Mega Satan with everyone except the Lost. Without a doubt. I don't think this file has any complete post-it notes. This might actually be my first Mega Satan win as well. Since Afterbirth, of course. Okay, this is going really easily because of Proptosis being so good, especially with the teeth. Get a tooth shot, Proptosis is just like silly. Yep. Dang, man, that's so strong. And so is Holy Light, of course. Holy Light is pretty silly as well. Overall, everything's just pretty silly with this. Never take your chances with the laser being the thing that he chooses to do. Just not worth it, man. Alright, so I should just be able to sit still, pretty much. Though that didn't work out, clearly. As long as the tears are moving in a straight line, I guess I can sit still. Doesn't matter. So these could hit me. Not even unlikely. But Mega Satan is dead. So I'll get an unlock here. Alright, you can get it. Long baby. And let's see what that means of our post-it notes. So Mega Satan's missing on everyone but Lazarus, yeah? My first Mega Satan kill. And that brings Lazarus to just missing the cathedral and Hush, which actually is really easy. That's like a good way to have things go. Yeah, that's gonna do it for today. I hope you enjoyed the episode. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.